In general, there are two kinds of graphic formats that we usually deal with. One is called as the SVG format, in which like it is called scalable vector graphics, and other is the raster format. So most probably you are familiar with the raster format, in which is like JPG, PNG, or GIF, or TIFF images. These are in raster format. What it means basically, there are some pixels. So the image is in particular size of like 1000 by 500 pixels. So each pixel has a color property which it defines, and the whole lot of pixels will define a picture. So that's a raster image. And in a vector image, the image is defined mathematically. So it's connection between two points which is defined mathematically. So that's a vector image. Okay. So I would like you to open an application called as Inkscape. Okay. The icon is like a mountain with a snow cap. And you should get a window like this when you open Inkscape. So this is one of the very powerful applications and my favorite application. I've been playing with it for some time now. And it has a lot of tools and it can do very good graphic works. Okay, so how many of you have your visiting cards? Let me ask you this question. How many of you have visiting cards? Okay, so did you design the card yourself? You designed the card yourself, okay. So you also designed the card yourself. And what all information does a visiting card contain? It has your name, your contact number, email, address, or if it is a business card, for example, if it is for promoting certain business, it will tell you what kind of services you offer in that business. So in this task, we'll first make a visiting card for yourself. Okay, so this is first task for the students also. Okay, so this is an A4 page size and visiting cards are not this big, right? So what I would like you to do is go to File, and click on New. Okay, so there is a lot of options of different page sizes here. There is CD cover, DVD cover, and there is business card also. Okay, so choose a business card from there. It will open in another window, and just maximize it. Business card size. In case it is appearing too big, so for zooming into any document, you can use the plus key on your keyboard, and zooming out, you can use the minus key. So now we'll add some text into it. So on this toolbar, there is A written over here, right? Okay, so if you take your mouse, it will show some help about that tool. So this will be true for all the tools that are listed on this side. So this one says create and edit text objects. So I just click on it. So, and what will happen is, my cursor changes now. You see, initially it was just a pointer. Now it is a crossbar with an A. So that means the text tool has been selected. Okay. Now I click with this and it will give me a cursor now. So that means that it is ready for typing, ready for taking an input. Okay, so I'll type my name here. And then when I want to come out of it, I can either click here. So this top, on the top there is an arrow. So this is the select and transform tool. Okay, so you can click on this and you'll come out of this thing. So a text will be created on the page. I'll put my email also here. Okay, so right now this is out of my page. This is not on my page, right? If I want to move it, so I go to the select tool again, and I click on this. Okay, so immediately you see the cursor again changes. There is a hand there, which will enable us to move it. So then I drag it so that I can place it wherever I want. Okay, so everybody is now ready to add text. Right? So now we'll see how do we change the font. So everybody knows what fonts are. So in this, there is an option of text in the menu. It says text and font. Okay, so once you press this, you will get a window like this. And all the fonts are listed here. Okay, if you press on this, it will show the font with a preview. Unless you apply here, the font won't change. Okay. So let's say I'll choose some font. We'll choose this one. Okay, and from this tool also you can change the absolute font size. I can change it, let's say, to 20 or something. So now you know how to add fonts and how to change the fonts and also to move around them in the document. Now let's say if I want to color it, how do I color it? So I just select this and you see there is a color palette downstairs. I mean, here is a whole lot of colors. These are not the only colors. You can drag this thing And you see there are quite a lot of many colors than there are initially visible. If I click on this, you'll see that the immediately text color changes. This is clear how to change color for the text. Is everybody okay with this? So since you have picked up very fast, we'll immediately go to the next thing. So let's say you want to add a background color to this page. This is right now white. There is nothing here really. Okay. So there is this tool which is fifth in the row. It's called Create Rectangles and Squares. Okay, so I click on this. I'll just drag it like this. Okay. So I create a rectangle of approximately same size as the page. What has happened now is the rectangle is on the top of the text that we have put. We want to put the rectangle behind the text. Okay. So use the page down key. It will put the rectangle back. Right now the Amit is not visible because like the color of Amit and color of this rectangle is same. Okay. So I'll just change that to something lighter and we will see. Okay. So the color is changed now. All the objects that are possible, there are two possible colors. Okay. So one is called as the fill color and one is called as the stroke color. Okay, so this yellow thing that you see here is the fill color and this is the stroke color. So I can remove the stroke color. So I can only have a border here. Okay. So you can make objects just with a border. There is no inside color there. Or you can have objects which have no border but just the inner filling. Okay. So you can have different colors for this or you can have same colors also. So let's say you want to add a border. The first option in object is fill and stroke. And the shortcut is Control Shift F if you want to know. So there are two options. So fill option is there. So you can see the fill color is yellow color. I have chosen the wheel option. And the wheel option is interesting because I can see live color changes here as I change the wheel. Okay. So I can choose any color that I want. I can see fit. And similarly with stroke. So this cross here denotes that you don't want any fill. And there is next option is gradient. Okay, linear gradient. So how many of you know what a gradient is? Can you explain what a gradient is?
Like, at least in terms of graphical representation, we define a gradient as something whose density value decreases a ramp or a slope.
Okay, a slope is an example. Or let's say a temperature gradient can be there. And as you go out of this room, I mean, temperature will gradually increase. I mean, if this door was not closed, I mean, it would have been the case. So we have selected gradient right now here. So you have a slight gradation of color going from orange to white. Okay, so this is another option for fill color. So let us see what else it has. Then there is a circular gradient also, or radial gradient. So if you give it, so this is something that you see. So this is useful more for circular objects or like objects which have like arcs and all that. It's much better used with that. And finally, we have a pattern. Okay, so you can have different patterns here. So let's say if I want a checkerboard here, I can use checkerboard also. But this may not be useful for a visiting card. So what I'll do is I'll stick with my flat color. Okay. There are very similar options for stroke paint as the fill paint, and you can change the color using that. And there is also something called a stroke style. Okay, so that's another option. And then you can have different types of strokes. So you can have dotted lines or solid line. Okay, so this is about stroke, and in stroke also you can have gradients like this. Okay, now I'll give you a task. Create a circle with red as the fill color and blue as the stroke color. Now this will let us look like this. This is 0 right now, so it's not showing. Now if I select on this, you'll have something called as width and height, W and H here. Okay. Now this is not a perfect circle, right? If I want a perfect circle, what do? So I can go to this W and H and I can change this manually. Let's say I put it at 50 and I height for height also I put it at 50 and then I lock it. Okay, so there is a lock there. So if I lock this, what happens? The aspect ratio doesn't change. So this will be very useful to you when you are dealing with complex objects or even fonts or something like that. So now what happens is if I change any of the height or width value, let's say I put it at 35 this value also changes by 35. If it was not locked, then it won't change by 35. It will stay what it is. Okay, so it will depend on what object you choose. Okay, so everybody is okay with this much. So should we see some other tools also? Okay, so there is a tool like pentagon and a star is given here. It says create stars and polygons. Okay, so with this you can create some stars. So by default you will get 5 corners to a star. Okay, if you want to increase the corners, there is an option called corners. You just increase them. Okay, and instead of a star, if you want a polygon, you just change this and you'll get a polygon. So all types of polygons are possible. Students like this tool very much. I mean, when they first start using Inkscape, they'll decorate their pages or like their documents with lot of stars. Okay, so this is something that I've observed across colleges, and perhaps in your college also you'll observe this. Okay, then there is another tool called a spiral tool. So as it says, it creates some spirals. Okay, so it will create spirals, and you can also change some properties of the spirals. It is here, no? It's got transparency 0%. Opacity should be always 100%. Okay, so some of you might face this problem. You draw the object, but the object is not visible. Okay, so I'll just try to address this issue. Okay, so in the stroke and fill option, there are two more things. There is something called as A. So this is the alpha channel. So what does this alpha channel do? Is, let's say this is by default at 255. If I reduce it, you'll see it is becoming more and more transparent. So it may happen that sometime this might be at zero or this might be very low. So you won't be able to see the object. Okay, and there is another option called as opacity. Okay, so this again produces the same effect. So in case you don't see any object if you draw it, just see if these values are zero or like very close to zero. This is like a pitfall. I mean, you might end up, sometime it you might change it accidentally and you don't know this, but this might happen with you, and it has happened with some of you. Then there is something called as a pen tool. Okay, so with this you can draw straight lines with which you can connect different objects, and you can create shapes also. So this is very useful when you are doing some things. Then there is another very interesting tool, so something called as calligraphy tool. So it can create calligraphic shapes for you. So you can set the angle of the brush and all that. So has anybody done calligraphy? I mean, you have done calligraphy. You also have done. Okay, so you can actually set the pen size and pen type in this. All the options are there. And you can really draw some very good calligraphic images using this. Okay, so this is the basic tools. Okay, I'll show you just one more tool. This is called the spray tool. Okay, so let's say I select this star and I want a lot of these stars to appear all over screen randomly. I mean, I don't want any order in them. I just want them to appear randomly. So I just click on this spray tool and I just click with this. So any object that you have selected will get sprayed with this spray tool. So let's say this page size and this size is not matching. So if I want to align it exactly to the page, what do I do? So first of all, on the right hand corner, there are two options here. One is this thing and one is a grid kind of thing, and there is a page option above here. So I'll click on this page option. So it says snap to the page border. Okay, so what it will do is any object that you take near the page border, it will just snap it to it. It will attach to it. So we'll see how this works. So I move this here and I just leave it, and okay, so it attaches there, and then you just reduce this size. This is like a more like a crude way of doing it. So if you really want to do it in an absolute way, go to the document properties. So the key for this is Control Shift D. So here you see the exact size of the document. So this is 85 by 54 millimeters. Okay, so once you know this size, you can actually put this size here. Okay, so this is how you make it. If you want to change exact dimensions of this thing. So let us finish the visiting card first, and then we'll go on to the next task. Looking what? Great. Ah. can publish books also using this. हाँ बोलिए. ये opacity जो है ना, इसका transparency 0 पे सेट हो गया.
Stroke का.
हाँ. नहीं तो वो उसका aspect ratio चला जाएगा.
See, when as an artist, when you are working on each object, you have to do all the work. So, though your canvas is just a visiting card, you may want to work now only on your name. So, let's just work on the name. What's your name?
My name, Arunain.
How do I spell?
A-R-U-N.
Arun. I can only use outline for the name and make sure that there is no fill for it. See, as Amit said some time ago, every object in Inkscape has two properties. One is outline, that is stroke, and then the fill. Now, even the letters that you type also have an outline as well as a fill. Could we give outline to Arun? And then eliminate the fill color. And secondly, sometimes what happens is artists don't like the computer kind of things because every letter looks very similar. So what I will do in that kind, I will convert this entire thing into a path. Path would mean that each of these letters can be actually converted into a path. So can you convert this into a path?
So I go to object.
Path.
Object to path. So now instead of a font, I mean this has become a Inkscape object. I mean, like you have rectangles and other things. Initially, it was a font. This is no longer a text now. This is just some shape.
It's available for a lot of manipulation now. Maybe what you can do is, you can select. Okay, now can you see? There are a lot of dots at every place. So like I can actually now change the letters like this a little bit. So let's say I would want this a little top like this, and this one as well. Now see, so this is what graphic artists do. How many of you actually worked with something like CorelDRAW or Illustrator? Okay, so if you have known that, you would know this as well, because the tools and the sets and everything is exactly same. However, there is one major difference. And the major difference is, if you save an object in CorelDRAW, what is the file extension? Which is proprietary, bad. This one is more advanced than PostScript. This is called SVG. So if you save this file, it will be saved as SVG. Okay, now what we can do is, why don't you save this file, only that visiting card part of it, and then load it on a Firefox and see what happens. So all your drawings that you make on Inkscape are directly uploaded on studio.tis.edu, which means that these are ready for the web. One major difference between an SVG file and this one is something like this. You know, you can actually go on increasing its size. The size, it will not pixelate, unlike a picture. If you have a picture and you keep on increasing its size, what happens? That's called pixelation. But you won't happen to have that kind of thing when you work with SVG. So one other thing that you could possibly do is, to visit Inkscape gallery. And before you visit the Inkscape gallery, who is going to teach you the rest of the Inkscape? The Inkscape can teach you the rest of the Inkscape. It will give you a tutorial which is done using the Inkscape itself, Inkscape basics. All that you have to do is just follow that thing and you can edit that file itself. Tutorial helps you to do some changes while you're reading. Don't worry, it's like a sandbox. So you can keep selecting objects, make them big, small, and all that, all the operations that you're doing, and you'll be able to become a master of Inkscape.